Let's do this.
It's so beautiful. Oh my god. Alright, we rolling? Yeah. Oh, it's done. Oh my god, look at that. New lion cub piece. Oh. New monkey piece. Oh. Okay, let's do this. Get to the part of the set that everyone wants. Elephant, elephant. I just want the elephant. Ooh. Oh, so cool. Oh my god. Why is this one in a bag? The other one isn't. Okay. This is interesting. Okay, seeing how it all works. Wow. Yeah, look at that. Okay, alright. Cool. What? Oh, of course. Needs a technic. Ah. There we go. Alright, so it's a very different build to the other one. Oh, I love it! Oh, this is the best thing Lego has produced all year. The tusks are the same pieces. I love that too. Classic Lego. Alright. Oh, look at that! It's here! It's here! Oh my god. Ah. G'day everyone, Bin Chicken Bricks here. Today we're looking at the two different Lego elephants that have been put out over the years. Crazily, it's been 18 years since we've gotten a Lego elephant. This first one on the right here is the original from 2003, and he actually only appeared in two sets, and they were under the Orient Expedition line with Johnny Thunder. This specific elephant here came out in set number 7414, whilst his counterpart came out in the 7418 Scorpion Palace, and the difference is the colour. So this guy is a lot darker, whilst the other one was a lot lighter. And if you exclude the brick-built elephants and the weird Lego Friends-style elephants, and the mammoth, of course, it has been 18 years since we've gotten an elephant, and so finally Lego has decided to release this one here with the new Lego City Africa range. And I think that was a bit of a loss, a bit of a lost opportunity, just making it a Lego City line. Like, they should have made it a specific, an African line, rather an Africa Adventures sets or something like that, rather than just under Lego City. I think they work out a bit bland. But anyway, moving on to the comparison, first we'll take a look at the original elephant from 2003. So as you can see, he's quite a bit larger than the other elephants. When it comes to accuracy, I think he probably doesn't look as realistic as the newer elephant. They both share the same trunk pieces, and he has a lot more posability, so you can stand him up. Oh, whoops. you can stand him up on his hind legs. Well, I'll show you how he comes apart. So these are the original old Lego animal legs, and the body. So these pieces were actually used for some of the original Lego dinosaurs back in the day, and I'll take them right apart. As you can see, the original Lego elephant comes apart into quite a few different pieces, so there is quite a big buildability aspect, which adds a lot to the playability aspect of the elephant. The fact that you have to put it together from so many different pieces, and that something that the new elephant I think is really lacking. It's interesting, I think, to see how the body comes together with these old animal body pieces. So they haven't used these pieces since the early 2000s, and it's pretty clear that they're not going to be coming back anytime soon. But it's interesting to think what it was like to have a sort of more universal body that all the large Lego animals had back in the day. So this is just sort of the assembly process. Interesting, the trunk and the tail piece are actually the same for the ends of the trunk. And you can adjust the tail as well if you want to make it higher or lower. Interesting that the ears, you can take the ears on and off. Now, I wonder if that was a choice because maybe they were going to do larger ears in the future. Now, this old elephant does have the original style for the Lego, for the eyes for the original Lego animals, where it was sort of just a stud or a hole. I don't mind it too much, but I can understand why some people might find it a bit creepy. Now, you can also put round objects in this elephant's mouth, as you can see. So you could put like a branch or something in there for it to eat. And you can also take the trunk pe the sorry the tusk pieces off if in case you wanted to make it represent a female Asian elephant who don't have trust tusks. I think the trunk is where this elephant stands out quite a lot because you can adjust it a lot more than the new elephant. The new elephant just has this one trunk piece that you can either put backwards or forwards, whilst the older elephant, if you want him to reach a higher branch or just have it hanging down low. Although you can't just have it straight, which I guess the new one does look a bit better just for easy aesthetics. Now the head, of course, on the old one, the head is a lot more posable as well. So if you want him to bend right down to reach for a drink or up like that, you can also turn side to side. Whilst the new one's head isn't as poseable, you can make him turn up and down a little bit, and you can go side to side, but you can't physically move the head around like up and down like you can with the old one. For the body shape, I think the new one is a lot more accurate. Whilst the old one, the playability does sort of take away from the accurate shaping of the elephant itself. And I think it's pretty cool that they both use the same tusk piece. So they've been using that same piece for quite a long time. And you can put in smaller tusks as well if you want your elephant to have smaller tusks. So my biggest gripe with these elephants is which elephants are they supposed to represent? So in the world there's African and elephants and there's Asian elephants. African elephants are quite a lot larger than the Asian elephants, and Asian elephants are quite a lot smaller. And whilst the original one was in the Orient Expedition sets, which were set in Asia, and you could conclude that it was an Asian elephant that you'd be, that this one was supposed to represent. Whilst this one, the new one, is from the Lego City sets that are based in Africa. So it's supposed to be an African elephant. But the ears are much too small, in my opinion. And I think this is probably a cost-cutting issue. Lego doesn't want to have to do two different molds for two different types of elephants. And that's sort of understandable. The original one had ears that you could swap out. Potentially, I thought maybe they would make a larger earpiece if they wanted to do one in Africa. That might have been the idea behind that, but I'm not sure. And then there's the size as well. African elephants and Asian elephants are very different when it comes to size. So we'll put the camera down here to sort of give you a better perspective and put a minifigure here. Now, this one's size is more accurate to an African elephant, even though it's supposed to be an Asian elephant. And this one's size is more accurate to an Asian elephant, even though it's supposed to be an African elephant. And I think that's the biggest problem that I have with these two elephants, is that they're just, in terms of size, really, really bugs me right there. But I'm very happy that we've got this new elephant piece, and overall, I'm pretty satisfied with it. I'm not really sure which one I prefer, to be honest. The original one is certainly a lot more nostalgic to me, because it's part of my childhood, and I remember getting to ride this elephant in the old Indiana Jones video game. They actually used this model elephant in that video game, which I thought was pretty cool. And I think there were a couple other LEGO video games that this one appeared in, because it was the only elephant mold we had for so long. And because it only appeared in two sets, it's quite expensive now on the aftermarket as well. But people can finally have a minifigure scale elephant. And like I said before, I just wish that they had made like an Africa adventure theme or something more, a bit more exciting than just a Lego city in Africa, which, I don't think is as interesting as something like Johnny Thunder or Orient Expedition like we had back in the day. I'm quite happy with the new model, but I like the old model as well. And I just hope that we see a lot more in new sets, and that this new elephant isn't kept away for another 18 years. But either way, I'll be getting a few of the new ones so that I can create a whole herd of elephants. So I'm excited to do that. Thanks so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Bin Chicken out.